Okay, now what happened in the last class, we'll just revise a bit and go further in this session regarding the concept reducible equations. And these equations can be reduced into a pair of linear equations, and they can be solved further. So let us do that quickly. Now I am going to present the screen for the remaining part of the class. So okay, let us see this one. Now in the last class, I think the computer screen is being shared, right? In the previous class, what we have done is this. We took the equations from the exercise directly, and the equations are these: 4 by x plus 3 y equal to 14, 3 by x minus 4 y equal to 23. To solve these equations, we adopted a method, that is, instead of 1 by x, we were writing a, so that the equations can be reduced into a pair of linear equations like this. When 1 by x is a, 4 by x will become 4a, and 3 by x will become 3a. So two equations are formed. These are the linear equations, a pair of linear equations. They can be solved in any method, either substitution method or elimination method. So I used elimination method here. First equation I multiplied by 4, then second equation by 3. Thereby the coefficients of y are equated, and we got 25a equal to 125, and a value is 5. Similarly, we also got the value of y by substituting this value of a in equation 1 like this. So a equal to 5, therefore 4 into a, 4 5 the 20 plus 3y equal to 14, or 3y equal to 14 minus 20, that is minus 6, or y equal to minus 6 by 3 equal to minus 2. Now these are the values, a equal to 5, and x value, actually a equal to 5, but 1 by x is a, 1 by x is a, therefore 1 by x equal to a equal to 5, therefore x will be the reciprocal of 5, x equal to 1 by 5, and y value already we obtained. We also saw one more problem of this kind: 6x plus 3y equal to 6xy, 2x plus 4y equal to 5xy. And to convert the equations, to reduce the equations to a pair of linear equations, we divided both the equations by xy on both sides, and this is what happened on division. We obtained 6 by y plus 3 by x equal to 6, and we arranged further with the x first and y next. 3 by x plus 6 by y equal to 6. Similarly, the second equation is becoming 2 by y plus 4 by x equal to 5, or this is 4 by x plus 2 by y equal to 5. And then further we let 1 by x equal to a and 1 by y equal to b. Therefore, the equations can be written as 3a plus 6b equal to 6, 4a plus 2b equal to 5. Then we solve the equations. Children, all this, it's only a revision. In the last class, we have checked, we have seen these in detail. So I am going a little bit faster. So when we subtracted equation 1 minus 2, 3 times of equation 2, equation 2 I multiplied by 3, so that the b coefficients are equated. Then we subtracted, and subtraction b coefficient, b terms will be getting cancelled. It will be 3a minus 12a, that is minus 9a equal to minus 9, or a equal to 1. And we substituted this value in equation 2 to get the value of b like this. So 2b equal to 1, or b equal to 1 by 2. Further, we equated 1 by x equal to a equal to 1. Thereby, the value of x will be 1, of course. 1 by y equal to b equal to 1 by 2. Here x equal to 1. And y, 1 by y equal to 1 by 2, therefore y equal to 2. These are the values we obtained on simplification like this. So this is about the reducible equations. We also saw this problem on the other day. 152x minus 378y equal to minus 74 minus 378x plus 152y equal to minus 604. The equations seem to be having larger numbers as the coefficients of the variables x and y. So normal methods will not work here. So we adopted a process like this. We added both the equations this way. When we added, we got minus 226x minus 226y equal to minus 678. And 226 is a common factor for x and y, both x and y here, minus 226. So we divided the entire equation by 226. Even the constant term is 3 times minus 226. Therefore, we obtained a smaller equation as x plus y equal to 3. Then, we subtracting equation 2 from equation 1 like this, after changing the symbols, we got 530x plus 530y equal to 530, and we divided this equation by 530. Thereby we got a smaller equation, x minus y equal to 4. Let that be 4, and equation 3 and equation 4 are further added to get the value of 2x to be 4 or x equal to 2. When x equal to 2, x plus y equal to 3 or y equal to 1. X equal to 2, y equal to 2, y equal to 1 is the solution for this pair of linear equations in two variables. Now, let us see from here, I think we have to learn. This was not taught to you in the last class. This is a similar problem, children, to the previous one also we did in the same way. So we adopt the same process. Varshita, are you following? T. Varshita?
Sir.
Kaushik, are you following?
Yes, sir.
Very good. All of you, look at the screen, follow the things whatever I am giving on the board. Now, here, 217x plus 131y equal to 913. 131x plus 217y equal to 827. Two equations. Quite large numbers are given as coefficients of x and y as under constant terms. So we are going to add them first. On adding these two, 217x plus 131y equal to 913, 131x plus 217y equal to 827. When you add these, you are getting 348x plus 348y equal to 1740. And 348 is a factor of all the coefficients there. So we will divide the entire equation by 348, thereby obtaining x plus y equal to 5. Right. Next, we subtract equation 2 from equation 1. That is, again, we write the equations one below the other, change the symbols for the second equation, minus, minus, minus here for all the terms and the constant. And then, as you subtract, 217 is bigger, so 217 minus 131 is 86. Here also, minus 217 is bigger than 131, of course, numerical value. So, the number obtained will be minus 86y, that is equal to 86. Then, so x minus y, 80 divided by 86, you are getting x minus y is equal to 1. Now, 3 and 4, you see quite small equations we obtained. So now, adding 3 and 4 like this, we get 2x equal to 6 or x equal to 3. And then, substitute this value in the first equation, we obtain the value of y as 2. Simple equations. Therefore, children, this is one problem of the same model what we discussed earlier. Now you can all take a screenshot or note down quickly. Mahesh, are you following? Mahesh?
Yes, sir.
Very good, Mahesh. Keep doing the work, and we don't know when the school will be opened, but still the classes are going on regular basis. You also should learn on regular basis. concentrate on what we are teaching here and practice and practice and practice. Only that will make you perfect all the time. Right. Now let us look at the next problem. Here we go. This is an example problem, an exercise problem from optional exercise 3.7 in the 7th one, 4th one. A minus b into x plus a plus b into y equal to a square minus 2ab minus b square. That is equation 1. A plus b into x plus y equal to a square plus b square. That is equation 2. Now, we are to solve this one using elimination method, children. Let us solve this by elimination method. The first equation, if you observe, a minus b is the coefficient of x, a plus b is the coefficient of y. But here in the second equation, x plus y, for both x plus y, x and y, a plus b is the coefficient. Therefore, we expand the second equation, the LHS of the second equation is particularly, so that you will have x with a separate coefficient, y with a separate coefficient, and we try adding them. So let us expand. We'll subtract equation 2 from 1 after expansion like this. Now a minus b into x plus a plus b into y equal to a square minus 2ab plus minus b square. That is the first equation. Second equation I expanded. That means I multiplied both x and y inside the brackets. See, a plus b into x, a plus b into y equal to a square plus b square. Did you all understand this step, children? Anwar?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mavya Sri. Did you understand?
Sharon? Yes, sir.
Sharon, Stutipriya?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Very good. Now, we are going to subtract. On subtraction, symbols will change automatically. See, minus, minus, minus here everywhere. Then, here for the first one, a minus b is different from a plus b, but when you write a minus b minus a minus b, you have to write within the brackets that the whole thing is the coefficient of x there. So a minus b into x. Here a plus b into y and minus of a plus b into y, together they will get cancelled. They will get cancelled here, and then minus a plus minus here a square minus a square gets cancels, and here what is left out is minus 2ab will be left out, minus b square and minus b square minus 2b square. From the right side, if left side, if you see, the coefficient will become smaller like this, minus 2b. A and a plus a minus a are getting cancelled, and minus 2b is the coefficient of x there. Here if I take minus 2b as a common factor, within the brackets I have to write a plus b. Now minus 2b is a common factor for both LHS and RHS, so we'll eliminate that like this. Minus x equal to minus 2b into a plus b by minus 2b. Minus 2b minus 2b are cancelled, a plus b is left out. Now let us write this a plus b in the first equation to obtain the value of y. So substituting this value of x in equation 1, we get like this, a minus b already there, in place of x I write a plus b, and here already a plus b x, a plus b into y is there, I am writing that, and minus a square minus 2ab plus minus b square is there on the right side. When you multiply these two, a square minus b square will come. You know that because of the identity 3, a minus b into a plus b is a square minus b square, and plus a plus b into y is equal to this much. And if you observe very closely, on either side we have a square plus with plus symbol, b square with minus symbol, so they will be cancelled automatically like this. So a plus b into y you leave on the left hand side, and on the right hand side a square minus 2ab minus b square, from the left hand side a square and minus b square is brought this side as minus a square plus b square. Automatically a square term and b square term are cancelled. Then we are left with minus 2ab on the left side, on the right side, and a plus b into y on the left side. So y value is minus 2ab by a plus b. Therefore, of course, we got the answer here, x equal to a plus b, y equal to minus 2ab by a plus b. Now, you all can make a note of this one, and we'll move on to the next problem. A very important problem, children. This is a very important one. This was given in the final exam once or twice, but many people, many of your elderly brothers and sisters left the problem. They were frightened of the problem. So, but you should not, right? Come on, practice this one. Though it is looking a bigger one, it is on simplification it becomes smaller. And if you practice it twice, it will be easy for you. Okay, practice it. Now, shall I move on to the next question, Kaushik? Yosri Charan, Venkatesh.
Sir, okay.
Shall I move on
sir.
To the next
yes,
problem?
Sir.
Yeah. I
think yes,
you
sir.
Have, you
yes,
have,
sir.
Right. You noted. Right, right. We'll move on to the next problem. Here, in the beginning of the chapter, we learned about the consistency conditions on comparing the coefficients of x and y in the equations a1 by a2, b1 by b2, c1 by c2, the ratios we have taken, and we compared the ratios. On comparing the ratios, we also generalized certain things. What are those? If in the equation, suppose in a pair of equations, the ratios of x coefficients, ratio of x coefficients is not equal to ratio of y coefficients, a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, then such a pair of equations will have unique solution. The graph of such equation, the pair, such pair will be intersecting lines. Okay, all this, the pair is called consistent. All this we learned. Now here, on those consistency conditions, we have a question here. For which values of a and b will the following pair of linear equations have an infinite number of solutions? Infinite number of solutions. Infinite number of solutions means here, children, we have to adopt another one, that is another condition. A1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. So firstly we will write what is a1 by a2, what is b1 by b2, what is c1 by c2 in an orderly manner. a1 by a2, the coefficient, ratio of coefficients of x, 2 by a minus b, and b1 by b2 is 3 by a plus b. c1 by c2 is, actually you should write minus 7 by minus of all this. Why? Because the equations are not in the standard form. Whether you write like that or directly this way, both will work out. Of course, the same symbol you have to, whatever symbol is there on the right hand side, you have to write that. So 7 by 3a plus b minus 2 is the ratio of c1 by c2. Now let us compare the ratios a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to, infinitely many solutions, sorry, for infinitely many solutions all three ratios must be equal. No solution, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2 is for parallel lines and no solution. Okay, I told in reverse in the beginning. Okay, no problem. Now a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2 is the condition to be adopted here. Now let us understand, let us equate a1 by a2 and c1 by c2 first, right? That means 2 by a minus b equal to 7 by 3a plus b minus 2, and when you cross multiply you get 3 into 2 6a plus 2 into b 2b, 2 into 2 minus 4 equal to 7 into a 7a, 7 into b minus 7b here. Now all a and b I'll bring on to the left side so that I can make form an equation clearly here like this. 6a and of course all these 6A, 2B are brought to the right hand side, you think like that. Then what happened? 6A is brought this side, 7A minus 6A, it is simply A. Minus 7B, minus 2B this side, that will be minus 9B. This minus 4 is left this side, and later on the equation is flipped to have A minus 9B equal to 4. I think you got the, you understood this.
Yes, sir.
Now, right. Now, very good. Now, let us compare the first two ratios. 2 by A minus B equal to 3 by A plus B. Again, cross multiply. 2 into A plus B, that is 2A plus 2B equal to 3A minus 3B. Then, when you bring 2A to the right hand side, 2B also to the right hand side, what will happen? This side it is 0 and we flip of course, and 3A minus 2A, A, and minus 3B, minus 2B, minus 5B equal to 0. Remember the equations, A minus 9B equal to minus 4, A minus 5B equal to 0. We are going to either add or subtract to get the values of A and B first. That's all. So this again, we are again going to solve the linear equations. They are also, be up on comparing the ratios of coefficients, we obtained two linear equations and we have to solve them for A and B now. Okay? If you know, make a note of this one or take a screenshot, we'll move on to the next one. Next step of this exercise, this problem. Yeah. Now, subtracting equation 2, equation 1 from equation 2, first equation I write down below and second equation on the top, A minus 5B, you can see A minus 5B is 0, A minus 9B equal to minus
1. Sir, A equals to 5 and B equals to 1, sir.
Very good, very good. Who said this? Suhana?
Suhana, sir.
Very
yes,
good,
sir.
Very good, Suhana. That's nice. Now, A, when you subtract A, you can cancel A on subtraction, symbols will change on subtraction. Here you will get plus 9b minus 5b, it is 4b equal to 4 plus 4 or b equal to 1. And substituting this value in equation 2, 5 A minus 5 into 1 equal to 0 or A equal to this 5, I'll bring this side, A equal to 5. This is the value. Now, A equal to 5, B equal to 1, the pair of equations has infinitely many solutions. Now let us see another question of the same type. Let's go through this one. For which value of k will the following pair of linear equations have no solution? Now for no solution, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. That is for no solution. Okay. Now here we compare the ratios. Here a, in the first equation, a1 is 3, b1 is 1 and c1 is, of course, minus 1, I have to write up 1 also, you can, no problem. And so in the second equation, coefficient of x, that is a2 equal to 2k minus 1, b2 equal to k minus 1, c2 equal to 2k plus 1 or minus of 2k plus 1. Therefore, a1 by a2 equal to 3 by 2k minus 1, b1 by b2 equal to c at 1 by k minus 1, c1 by c2 equal to minus 1 by minus of 2k, minus 2k minus 1 or 1 by 2k plus 1. Now, let us apply the condition. For no solution, a1 by a2 equal to b1 b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. So, we are writing the equations like this. 3 by 2k minus 1 equal to 1 by k minus 1, not equal to 1 by 2k plus 1. Then, on comparing the first two only, we'll take, we'll choose only the first two. Third one we don't choose, for which value of k they are asking. Okay. Now 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1. Cross multiply. 3 into k, 3k. And 3 into 1, of course here minus, therefore minus 3 equal to 1 into 2k, 2k. 1 into minus 1, minus 1. So bring this 2k this side, 3k minus 2k, k. And 3 this side, it will become plus 3. Minus 1 plus 3 will be plus 2. Right? So, this is k equal to 2. So, for k equal to 2, the given set of equations, has the given pair of equations has no solution. Okay? Now, okay, you all write down you can copy, either copy or take a screenshot quickly, so that we can have more questions on this chapter. Right. Now let us see more questions.
Sir, can you show the?
Yeah. Finished.
Can you show the previous slide, sir?
Previous slide. This one. Yeah. You can note down now.
Yes, sir.
All right. This is the next slide. Those who want can have a screenshot quickly or note down. Okay. Shall we move on to the next question?
Yes, sir.
Poorna Kamlesh, did you finish writing? Poorna Kamlesh.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now we'll move on to the next one. Here, there are many questions. Not many. Just 5 questions I wrote for you. I picked some questions for you, which can be practiced further to have to understand these methods. Understand these processes. For what value of k, the pair of equations given have no solution? For what value of k will the equations represent coincident lines? All these are different questions on this particular concept of finding or comparing what is this one called? Consistency conditions, right? On the application of consistency conditions. And lastly, I added one more question. For you to do quickly. Now, let us solve 1 or 2 questions from here and close the class for today. For that, I am going to have this presentation again. Now, the set of questions I will show you again. These are the set of questions for what value of k, etc. I am taking the first question here. For what value of k? These equations will have no solution, right? Again, compare the ratios a1 by a2, that is 8 by k, and b1 by b2, 5 by 10, and c1 by c2 is 9 by 15. Now, a1 by e2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c is not equal to c1 by c2 for a pair of equations not to have a solution. So, this one, we will compare only a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2. Thereby, we are getting 8 by k equal to 5 by 10 or k equal to, you can simplify it further. 5 by 10 means it is 1 by 2, 5 1s, 5 2s, and as you cross multiply, k equal to 16. So, for k equal to 16, the set of equations given here have no solution. They have no solution. Okay. Now let us move. If you want, you can take a quick note. Now fifth one also I am explaining here, children. The fifth one given here like this. The sum of two numbers is 13. The difference is 5. Find the numbers. What a simple small problem. Now check. Let the numbers be x and y. X plus y equal to 13, because the sum of the numbers is 13. Difference, let us think that x is greater, x minus y equal to 5, that is the difference. Now you add 1 and 2, you will get 2x equal to 18 or x equal to 9, and substitute this value in equation 1, that is 9 plus y equal to 13, thereby you get y value as 4. Let's try one more. If you all take a quick screenshot. Okay, shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. This one, this is the second one given in the questions here. For what value of k will the equations x plus 2y plus 7 equal to 0, 2x plus ky plus 14 equal to 0 represent coincident lines? They represent coincident lines means they have infinitely many solutions. for infinitely many solutions, a1 by a2 equal to b1 b2 equal to c1 by c2. So when you compare a1 and a2, here it is 1 by 2, coefficient of x in the first one is 1, second equation it is 2, so 1 by 2. For the first one, b1 is 2, b2 is k, c1 is 7, c2 is 14. So we are comparing these. You can take any two equalities, any two of the ratios, equate them, get the answer here. a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2. That means 1 by 2 equal to 2 by k, meaning you can take k into 1k equal to 2 into 2, 4. Any of the equations you can take and solve the same. So k equal to, for k equal to 4, the set of equations here has will represent coincident lines. Okay, as infinitely many solutions also you can say. The remaining problems, questions given here, you can solve and practice them. Okay, children, now we'll move on to